Coca-Cola, Sharp, Westpac, Gold Lotto, and simulcast on FM 104.
I'm Jonathan Coleman, and welcome to the concert event of the decade, John Farnham's Age of Reason, live from Expo. It's going to be a big night tonight. We're going to be going through some new songs from the brand new album. And behind me, you may have noticed, 25,000 people, which is just a fraction of the nearly 1 million people that made John Farnham's Whispering Jack album the most successful Australian album of all time. And somewhere in this 25,000 people is my Saturday Morning Live co-host and friend, Ian Dano Rogerson. Are you there, Dano?
Thanks, Johnny. Well, it's pretty hard to describe the vibe down here at the moment. The excitement level's incredible. Some of these people have been here since 10 a.m. this morning when the Expo gates first opened, and they've been rolling in here ever since, and the crowd, as you can see, is pretty well at capacity. I was lucky enough earlier on this evening to talk to some of the people in the audience. You seem pretty excited. What do you think you're going to be like by the time the concert comes around?
That's a good question, that one.
Yeah. What do you think of John Farnham?
He's excellent.
Yeah?
He's gorgeous.
If I were you, I'd play the ace, I think, is probably
no,
the best.
I'll lose if I do.
You'll
that.
Lose. How long have you been waiting here?
Since about 2 or 3 o'clock.
How much money have you lost?
I've won $4.
$4? Are you asking yourself, what are you doing here?
Yes, I have since 12 o'clock.
Are you a big fan of John Farnham?
Yes, I am. I love him. He's gorgeous.
Well, can you just, what does he mean to you?
Oh, it's just great.
It's great.
It's unbelievable.
You're the voice, try and understand it. Make a noise and make it clear. Whoa, oh, oh.
How long have you been here?
Since about 3.
Since about 3. You feeling a bit tired?
Yeah, stuffed.
Oh, don't worry. You'll get excited again.
Can't wait for him.
Oh, yes, I don't mind. He's a good voice, but I don't like his long hair. No, that's the only criticism I got about him. He always cut his hair. But he's a good singer, a good entertainer.
Well, there you have it, some very excited people. And as a matter of fact, I have two very excited people here from Home and Away, Alex Papps and Nicolle Dickson. Alex, how are you?
Good, I'm good.
What are you doing here tonight?
Well, we're both here to shoot some stuff for Home and Away tonight.
Oh, really? Yeah. Some secret stuff?
Well, yeah, a little bit.
And Nicolle, you're looking forward to seeing John Farnham?
Well, excitement is definitely the word.
Yeah?
Yeah.
And how long have you been waiting here?
Oh, today.
Yeah.
Since 11 o'clock.
That's
so,
incredible.
Yeah, we're really looking forward to it.
You can fiddle in the crowd behind us.
Well, that's right. We're amongst friends anyway.
Yeah.
Well, there you have it, the situation down here in the audience. Now, back to you, Johnny.
Thanks a lot, Dano. Dano gets all the easy job. It's not fair. Anyway, as you can see, there's 25,000 people, as I said. So it was very hard to get John Farnham into the concert tonight. They gave up trying to bring him through the crowd. They've actually brought him over from the hotel in a boat. So John Farnham is here. But before the concert starts, we thought we might take a look at some career highlights of this remarkable Australian.
Over the past 3 years, John Farnham has become a household name the second time around.
John and the album Whispering Jack hits the top of the music charts and stays there for 25 weeks. The album sells over 900,000 copies, goes multi-platinum, and becomes the biggest selling album in Australia ever.
It holds it up. No, it's perfect. Absolutely beautiful.
It's dramatic.
I like it.
Always sort of looking on the bright side and always keeping things funny, so we don't take things too seriously. I think that's important for a guy, especially someone in his position who has to follow up an album like Whispering Jack.
His singing's great and his whole stage thing's great, but he's a true entertainer in the true sense of the word, you know. I mean, nothing's too hard for him, whether it be autographs or just, you know, putting on a great show. It's fantastic work.
The Voice scoops the Australian Record Industry Awards and dominates Countdown's final night with the 1987 Outstanding Achievement Award.
It's John Farnham with the other
guys. Winner is John Farnham of West Brisbane.
Over the space of 1 year, John sells out two national tours. Jack is definitely back. January 1988, Bicentennial Fever, and John Farnham is named Australian of the Year.
Nothing I can really say. It's just like my big little brother that I want to travel with all the time. That takes me everywhere he goes.
Well, I think John's a bit of a phenomenon, really, you know, in his talent. But to work with, he's a very easy guy to work with. Great.
I can't get it now. Are you kidding?
Yeah.